Welcome again to Semantic Web Technologies. The first lecture, the web of data, and we have come to the third part of the lecture, and we want to talk about the importance of meaning. So we left the last part of the lecture with a question: how big is the web? How much information is in the web? And the problem was to cope with this information because we cannot make sense of it. So there is no way to express the meaning of information because HTML, as the main language that represents content in the web, is not able to formally express meaning, to formally express semantics. So the question was, what is the meaning? And to cope with this question, we first have to talk about a few fundamental concepts. And the first concept we have to talk about is, of course, semantics. So the lecture and the course is called Semantic Web. So of course, we have to talk about what does semantic mean. So the word comes from Greek, semantikos, means it pertains to the character or the study of meaning. And semantics itself is part of linguistics and is focused on sense and meaning of language or symbols of the language. So it is the study of interpretation of signs and symbols from a language as used by agents or communities within particular circumstances and contexts. So semantic asks, for example, how can I make sense, or how do I get the sense and the meaning of complex concepts, and how can they be derived from simple context based on rules that are fixed on syntax. So here's another concept that we have to explain. It's called syntax. And semantics, of course, depends on two other things. First, on context. We will talk about that later. And on so-called pragmatics. So let's keep in mind, semantic means the meaning. And it's the science and the study of sense and meaning of language and symbols. Next, we have to talk about syntax. Syntax comes before semantics, and it also comes from the Greek. Syntaxis means arrangement or ordering. And syntax is part of grammatics, and it denotes the study of the principles and processes, how sentences are constructed in particular languages. So in formal languages, for example, in computer science, syntax is just a set of rules by which well-formed expressions can be created from a fundamental set of symbols from an alphabet. And in computer science, of course, you know that syntax defines somehow the normative structure of data. So just think of the syntax of programming languages. So syntax tells you how you form your information and how to make valid sentences in a specific language. Whereas semantics tells you what is the meaning of this information that is pertained in the sentences of the syntax. Okay, so far so good. The next concept we have to talk about is context, because context really is important to make sense of the semantics and to determine the semantics, to determine the meaning. Context itself, it's now a Latin word, and it comes from contextus, it means interweaved, and this denotes the surrounding of a word or of symbols in an expression. Or it means the relationship of this expression to the surrounding expressions and to further related elements. So the context denotes all elements of any sort of communication that define the interpretation of the communicated content. So for example, we have the general context. It means the place and the time where the communication takes place and the interrelation of actions in a message. And on the other hand, there is the personal or social context. It means the relation between the sender and the receiver of the message. And of course, these relations determine how the information has to be interpreted, how the semantics really is in the end. And in the end, we have pragmatics. So every act of communication, the speaker or the sender follows or pursues a certain purpose with his act of communication. So this is pragmatics, and pragmatics also comes from Greek, pragma, it means action, and this reflects the intention by which the language is used to communicate a message. So in linguistics, Pragmatics denotes the study of applying language in different situations, and it also denotes, as we have told already, the intended purpose of the speaker. So pragmatics studies the way in which context contributes to meaning. And in the end, it tells you how also the semantics is manifested in a way. So context and pragmatics, they determine the semantics. And another concept is rather important in this context. Again, it's the experience. It means the knowledge that you have about the world. And experience considers all information that you have learned and put in context with the world you are living in. So for successful communication, this is important. First, information has to be transmitted correctly. You do this by the rules of syntax that determine what is a valid sentence, what is a well-formed sentence. And of course, the meaning of the transmitted information must be interpreted correctly. This is necessary for understanding the message. The meaning here is the semantics. And again, understanding depends on first the context of both the sender and the receiver of the message, and the pragmatics of the sender. It means what purpose did the sender try to achieve by choosing this form of the message. So the context of the sender and receiver depends also on the experience of both. It means the knowledge of the world they have both, of the knowledge of the sender and the receiver. So all these things put together are really mandatory and essential for understanding the meaning. So what you see here is the so-called semiotic triangle, and it depicts somehow what is happening inside your head and how does language really work. This is a rather old concept. It stems from Ogden and Richards in the 1920s. So for example, if I tell you a word, for example, jaguar, this is a symbol. And of course, if I use the word jaguar, this word stands for some object in the real world. But only by using the word, maybe I don't have any idea what I really mean because this word is ambiguous. It can denote several different things, as in the case of jaguar. You can mean, of course, the big cat. You can mean the car. Or as a computer scientist, maybe you refer to some operating system. So when you hear the term jaguar inside your head, some concept is popping up that will tell you what meaning is referred to by that symbol. And in the end, sender and receiver, they have to give sufficient information to disambiguate the semantics, to make it clear, to make it unique. So therefore, they need context. And of course, they need their own experience to put the context and the semantic in the right way to perceive the meaning of the message and to understand each other. We will come back in this lecture to this semiotic triangle again later on. So this is in general how language works, how communication works. And the problem here, of course, is, so what about the web? How does the communication work in the web? And not only related to us humans, but how can machines be able to participate in this kind of communication and to understand the information inside the web? To make for us humans the web usable with this huge amounts of information. And this will be the topic of the next part of the lectures when we try to explore the limits of the web.